Well, everyone, we have finally made it. Welcome to the freaking Magic Mountain announcement that we've been waiting for so hecking long. Why did this take so long? In all seriousness, though, welcome to my analysis of Wonder Woman Flight of Courage, Six Flags Magic Mountain's new for 2022 RMC Raptor coaster. A single rail coaster that we've known about since, what, like March of 2020 or something? I mean, I predicted it. I didn't really, like, know, but, like, I predicted this thing all the way back in February of 2020 when I initially released my Joker concept. But anyways, this Raptor is basically going to be identical to Jersey Devil Coaster. And if you guys do not know, I have ridden Jersey Devil Coaster, so I basically have like my own kind of review of this ride, even though I've already ridden it, but I haven't. So, let's go ahead and talk about this coaster and before we start comparing it to Jersey Devil Coaster. So first off, the stats of this coaster, it's kind of depressing. So when everyone was talking about how this coaster was going to be taller and faster and longer than Jersey Devil Coaster, while that is true, it's not by much. So for those of you who don't know, Jersey Devil Coaster sits at a height of 130 feet, has a length of 3,000 feet, and a top speed of 58 miles per hour. Wonder Woman Flight of Courage sits at a height of 131 feet, has a length of 3,300 feet, and has a top speed, of 60 miles an hour. So all in all, it's a foot taller, 300 feet longer, and 2 miles an hour faster. Will that hinder the ride experience? Probably not. And by that, I mean, it's probably just gonna be the same as Jersey Devil. Like, I don't see this coaster being significantly faster or better. On the bright side, this thing isn't gonna be any worse than Jersey Devil. So all of our thoughts about Jersey Devil Coaster, those are either gonna be identical to Wonder Woman, or just Wonder Woman will be a little better. So I'm hoping this one will be better. I mean, even though it's just a foot and an extra 2 miles an hour, it might be just enough to make it a little better. But ultimately, I think it really just comes down to, you know, weather and, you know, how long the ride has been running throughout the day, how many people are on the train, I mean. So anyways, I'm not really going to talk anything about the layouts. I mean, we already know what the layout's going to be. But something interesting I wanted to note is that, unfortunately, it doesn't look like we're going to get that connection between the DC Universe and the Metropolis area of the park like we all hoped for. So we really wanted that, at least I really wanted that, just because it would be a lot easier just to go straight from the DC to pretty much the other DC section, Metropolis, just straight there and not having to go through the boardwalk. But yeah, that's a little unfortunate, so oh well. But anyways, even without that, like, this is still gonna be a very beautiful coaster on the skyline. Like, I've already shown my renditions of it in No Limits 2. I'm sure you guys have probably seen those images or the flash concept I made a while back. But yeah, so I think it's gonna look really great. I mean, I've seen Jersey Devil with my own eyes, and, you know, I've ridden it, and it looks great. I really like the way these look aesthetically. And so, I mean, the colors, I mean, yeah, we already knew what they were going to be, yellow track, red supports, but I still wish it was going to be Joker themed, I'm sorry. But yeah, so aesthetically, it's going to be good, and ride experience, it's also going to be good. Now, since I have already ridden Jersey Devil Coaster, I have a fair idea of where this will place in the park for me, because if Wonder Woman rides identical to Jersey Devil, or even just slightly better, this still is barely going to be top 5 for me. So right now, my top 5 at Magic Mountain without Wonder Woman is: number 1 is X2, number 2 is Tatsu, 3 is Twisted Colossus, 4 is West Coast Racers, and 5 is Viper. And so if we throw Wonder Woman in this list, my top 3 is not changing. X2, Tatsu, and Twisted Colossus, all significantly better than Jersey Devil Coaster. And Wonder Woman. Yeah, they're the same ride. So when I look at West Coast Racers, I mean, I feel like I'm going to need a refresher, because if I ride West Coast Racers and then immediately ride this Raptor after, or vice versa, because that's probably what's more likely going to happen whenever this thing opens, I'll be sprinting straight to this ride and then going to West Coast Racers after or something. I don't know. But yeah, so those two, it might be a bit of a competition. And then I feel like this is probably going to have the edge over Viper. Once again, I'm going to need a refresher, because it has been a few months since I've ridden Jersey Devil Coaster. And by the time this opens, it'll have been a whole year since I've ridden Jersey Devil Coaster. So I'll ride this along with those other coasters I mentioned in the same day, and then I'll have my actual rankings. But for the time being, I don't really know if this is even going to be top 5. If it is, it's going to be number 5 or number 4. It's not in my top 3. I'm sorry. This ride's going to have to go like a whole 10 miles an hour faster if it's going to want to beat out Twisted Colossus for me. Because this thing is nowhere near as aggressive as Railblazer, because if you guys didn't know, I've also ridden that Raptor, And that is an insane roller coaster. So anyways, something else that I wanted to talk about was actually going to be the station. So obviously, like we know, it's going to be reusing Green Lantern First Flight Station. They've actually been making a lot of progress on that. They have the footers in the station, so they're ready to start building in there. And so, you know, it's going to be rethemed to Wonder Woman. By the looks of it, it looks like they're going to be reusing the bottom level queue. And then, you know, I assume it's just going to take the stairs back up to the top, just like how Green Lantern did. So I'm really excited to go back in this building. I mean, this was one of the coolest queues at Six Flags Magic Mountain with the whole pre-show setup and everything. So I'm really, really hoping to keep that and that they don't just hollow it out. I know they already removed a bunch of walls, but maybe they'll just redo it and put like a whole pre-show down there. But if they do something like what they did with West Coast Racers' bottom floor, where it's just an open floor with a few screens, like that'll be kind of disappointing. I mean, West Coast Racers' station is cool, but the Green Lantern one was so much cooler. Anyways, when we look at the actual loading station, we don't have any confirmation of whether or not this is going to have a moving station. So if you guys didn't know, the only other Six Flags Raptors, Wonder Woman Golden Lasso Coaster and Jersey Devil Coaster, those both have moving stations, meaning the train does not stop in the station. It keeps rolling, guests will get on one at a time as the train keeps moving forward, and then once it gets to the front of the station, once all the restraints are locked and checked, then it'll speed up a little and then go up the lift hill. We don't know if that's going to happen. I mean, with this one, it's the only Raptor so far that doesn't immediately go up the lift hill. It actually turns out of the station. Every other Raptor that's been built so far, it just goes straight from the station into the lift hill without turning. This one has the little turn, so I'm not sure if it's going to be like Railblazer, where it's like a standard, it just stops in the station, guests get on and off, and then it'll dispatch. We don't know. If we can have that moving station platform, then yeah, I think the capacity will be significantly increased. I'm not sure how many trains they're planning on running this thing at once, because I know Jersey Devil can technically run 4, but usually they only run 2 or 3. And have one as a spare. But you know, considering Magic Mountain is not a seasonal park and they're open year round, I'm not sure if they can have that many trains running. So if they have 4 total trains, we're probably only going to be seeing a max of 3. I doubt we'll ever see 4 train operations on this, and even 3 is probably a little bit like, I don't really know. So I feel like 2 is probably the most realistic with this ride. 3 is going to be possible with the block systems. And so if we do have 3 with a moving dispatch station, or a moving loading station, sorry, then yeah, this will be a very high capacity ride. A lot of people were really concerned about these things with Magic Mountain getting a Raptor, just because everyone was like, oh yeah, no, it's going to have super low capacity in such a big park. Like, no. This thing probably has better dispatches and better capacity than like all the roller coasters around it. Maybe not Riddlers and Batman, because those are B&Ms, but look at Sunday the Ride. Like, that thing has horrible capacity. West Coast Racers doesn't have that good capacity. Apocalypse doesn't have that good capacity. Even X2. Like full throttle. Twisted has okay capacity-ish. I mean, the dispatches aren't the best, but yeah. Point is, this won't suffer capacity-wise as much as, you know, especially when talking about its replacement, or the ride it's replacing, Green Lantern. That had horrible capacity, so. But yeah, overall, I still think it's gonna be a pretty good coaster. Like I said, it's gonna be close to top 5. It'll definitely be one of the better coasters in the park. Like, I still think this is better than every B&M except for Tatsu in the park. And yeah, so I'm really excited to get to see this thing go vertical and, you know, capture the construction process and all that. That's going to be really fun. And then once member preview starts, maybe I'll get invited to media day. Maybe. I hope. Six Flags, please. Please, Six Flags, I'm begging you. I don't care that I work for nuts. I'll say it. This thing is way better than Ghost Rider. I'll take Jersey Devil Coaster over Ghost Rider. Stupid Ghost Rider. The ride sucks. It doesn't suck. It's just overrated. I'm sorry. Anyways, so when this roller coaster opens, I will be, you know, probably going to be there on its first day of member preview, just like I was with Jersey Devil Coaster. I'm going to be riding Raptors on their first day of operations. Let's get it. And yeah, and then I'll be able to capture all that. That's all going to be exciting. But for the time being, I'm going to thank you guys for watching this analysis video, and I'll see you guys in the next video, whatever and whenever that may be. Goodbye.